Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching for today. It's about 1 month after last release of most customizable Android 15 build of Infinity X 2.9. But developers of this team did solid comeback with release of their Android 16 based Infinity X 3.0 version. This build is now officially rolling out for all supported devices, and official GSI build is also available for all Android devices, which is maintained by developer doze. So any device can enjoy this build. In my opinion, this is the first highly customizable version of Android 16 build with most of essential features that will give next level of look for your Android 16 ROM. Today in this video, we are going to review all Android 16 features available in this build, all Infinity X features which are working, and also got some new interesting features. At the end of this video, I discuss some bugs of this GSI build. For you tech, always help to give new life to old forgotten Android devices with such useful mod content. If you think it's useful, then please like and press hype button to rank this video at the top in leaderboard points. Now without further delay, let's get started. For review of this ROM, I flashed it using doze loader on my OnePlus 9RT. I already uploaded new video how you can flash any custom GSI ROM via fastboot method. You can check that video from iCard link. If you check about device section of this new Infinity X 3.0, it's new officially supported GSI build for all treble supporting dynamic system devices. Maintainer of this build is doze. Security patches of this build is of latest July 2025. So new Infinity X providing up-to-date latest source base for your old device, so it's worth to try such ROMs. Now we will see all Android 16 features available and working in this build. Like previous Android 16 ROM we reviewed, this ROM also got new Android 16 QS panel user interface, new on and off animations of QS panel tiles, and new brightness slider looks very nice. ROM have Android 16 fresh notification look. At the bottom we get the new notification history and notification control center shortcuts. ROM also got Android 16 new revamped clear all button. ROM have same Android 16 new settings panel which have card like look for different options with new large rounded icons. It also got new user interface of Android 16 for on and off switches for different application settings. Android 16 new material look, colored clock on the always on display with clock, battery percentage details are working in this build and they are looking very nice. Except these user interface changes, ROM and new different Android 16 features like double press power button to open Google Wallet is available in this build. It also got long press power button to open digital assistant Gemini. New select and close shortcuts are available for recent panel. As ROM comes with the picture launcher, text or selection and sharing is working for select option. Android 16 new app live alert notifications are working. This shows you ongoing status of notifications for some specific applications like Swiggy, Blinkit, Zomato, etc. Similarly, it shows live activities of Google's new Android 16 spaceship Easter egg game. New feature of Android 16, that is battery health, is available in battery option of this ROM. So these are all working Android 16 features and new user interface we've seen. As I mentioned in the intro, this is the first Android 16 ROM added lots of working customization. You will find them in an Infinity X suite option available in setting application. Let's check out them one by one. All options of customization which were present in Android 15 versions are available here, like Monet customization. It have all Monet themes customization options. In themes option, all font styles, icon shapes, Wi-Fi, network icon packs are available, which will help to change the default look of your Android 16 version. In lock screen option, I especially like these lock screen clock font styles. Apply them and restart system UI using advanced power menu setting and enjoy the new lock screen clock look on always on display and lock screen. Next is new feature that you will find in a status bar called as status bar action chip. It's already available in old Infinity X2.9, but now it has some more advanced options. You can give compact look to this notification progress bar and can control its opacity. This is a compact look of ongoing notifications which have apps icon and its progress bar around it. It looks better than the old progress bar style. This notification is interactive, means by tapping on them you can open respective application. Also get the new show media progress bar, which will display ongoing media progress on your device. By tapping on this media progress bar, you get the new pop-up to forward or backward music track. In a QS panel option, you get different clock styles for QS header. All of them looks great, but my favorite is analog clock. If you are using pure black theme for your device, then to match with the pure black look, you get new option in a QS panel customization called as pure black QS panel. If you enable this toggle and restart system UI, and boom, your Android system QS panel looks very gorgeous with new pure black look. All power menu styles of old Android 15 Infinity X are available in buttons option of this ROM. Along with advanced shortcut, new cyberpunk style gives amazing look to your power menu. In navigation option, old app sidebar is added by team and it's working very good. You can open lots of app windows and app drawer and can do multitasking efficiently using this feature. In buttons option, old advanced long back gesture action feature is available and it's working great. By using this, you can open multiple shortcuts and application anywhere in the system and can boost your productivity. In miscellaneous setting, all old spoofing features are available like Google Apps, Tensor features and Play Integrity Fix. But now we got this new option to load Keybox XML file to bypass Play Integrity. Or you can also load your desired PIF JSON file. For gaming, we got unlock higher FPS option also. By using hide developer setting, you can hide developer option for some banking application with GTX developer setting. If it's on in your device, unlock screen record toggle helps you to remove 13 gig of screen recording file size limit. I got one option called as system haptic control. By using this option, you can increase or reduce haptic feedback for volume sliders, edge scrolling activities like scrolling recent panel, accessing Google Gemini, haptic feedback while scrolling settings panel, etc. Infinity X3.0 have dedicated game space application which have lots of options to provide you better performance and interference free gaming experience. New Infinity X have new OxygenOS dialer which have great clean user interface with call recording without announcement feature. So we discussed all features of new Infinity X3.0. Now let's talk about bugs of this build. First one is circle to search. It's not working for me even after updating Google application to newest version. Status bar punch-hole camera is not properly aligned, so it looks weird. You can temporarily solve it by applying hide and punch-hole cutout option available in display setting. But after every reboot or system user interface restart, it goes to default look. Under display fingerprint is not working, but you can use face unlock as alternative for this, which is blazing fast. All basic device and strong integrity checks are failing, but all highly secured banked applications are working fine for me. I didn't test Play Integrity Fix available in miscellaneous setting to fix this issue, but using custom keybox or by following our iCard video, you can bypass it easily. These are some minor bugs, except that everything is working for me. In my opinion, this is the first highly customizable Android 16 ROM till the date I tested. So you must try this build at least once. This is all about for today, guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.